Hello, everybody. And give it up for Andrew, guys. And for Misty, everybody from the Action for Assange crew. Thank you guys for coming out to this. As he said, my name is Krish Mohan. I'm a stand-up comedian. And I want to start by saying that after 2 decades of living in this country, at the end of 2019, I officially became a naturalized citizen of the United States. Thank you. I'm very excited to vote against my own interests. It's been a dream for every immigrant in this country. I have realized that in this country, though, a lot of people don't understand what their rights are, what the Constitution actually stands for, right? And I think one of the reasons is why we're here today is to fight for Julian Assange, is to be his voice when he has been ours for so long, right? I think a lot of people don't know what Julian has actually been going through. Before he was illegally imprisoned in Belmarsh prison, he was in the Ecuadorian embassy for 7 years. And a lot of the rhetoric that was surrounding that as well, he's freeloading at the Ecuadorian embassy. He's freeloading, you guys. Not being imprisoned in America. He's freeloading over there, which is ridiculous. And being in asylum shouldn't be a prison sentence with Wi-Fi. That shouldn't be the case, right? You should be celebrated for revealing war crimes. You should be celebrated for being a real journalist. But in America, that's not the case. They claim that he was freeloading. Well, I guess if that's the case, then the story of Rapunzel is just about a hot lady that's been freeloading off her parents, giving her a free tower and socialized haircuts, right? Or maybe the prisoners over at Guantanamo Bay are just freeloading, suckling at the teeth of the freedoms of the American torture program. That's probably what they're doing, right? I think it's important to know what Julian Assange really revealed about America. I think the most famous thing that he revealed was the collateral murder video, right? I think a lot of us here have seen it. If you haven't, it is proof that the American military killed Iraqi civilians and 2 Reuters journalists indiscriminately, yeah, making jokes along the way. Yeah, I think that pretty much proves that the policy that America has on the First Amendment is shoot the messenger. Quite literally, that is the policy that we have in America. I don't think Americans really understand what journalism is. We have a very odd relationship with journalism in this country, right? To most Americans, I think journalism is 2 pundits on the opposite side of the screen screaming at each other about, I don't know, whatever topic you want to choose, and Tucker Carlson desperately trying to gain control of his show again and hoping nobody drops the N-bomb, right? Like, fingers crossed. It's either that or they scream about Russia for about 3.5 hours, day in and day out, and that's what American journalism is supposed to be. But it's not. Real journalism, true journalism, is about fighting back against power. It's about telling the truth, about holding people in a position of power far more accountable than corporate journalism ever would. And that's what Julian Assange did. The collateral murder video is proof of that. And where does that put him? That puts him in prison. Not one person from the collateral murder video is in prison. One of the other things that he revealed was about Vault 7. The Vault 7 leaks pretty much revealed that the CIA is spying on us using smart technology, phones, cars, televisions, which means that Mike Pompeo, the former director of the CIA and America's deadliest care bear, that's what he looks like. That means that the CIA and Mike Pompeo pretty much watched everybody here masturbate. That's what that means. And don't pretend like people here don't use their phones to masturbate. We are in front of the state capitol. There is someone in there masturbating on their phone right now. There might be some of us out here doing that too. I would like to say that's the cost of freedom, because sometimes that happens. That's what that means, man. See, I do love, but again, for revealing Vault 7, Julian Assange is in prison. Meanwhile, Mike Pompeo gets to live free, terrorizing the Smurfs and pretty much everybody that's vaguely brown. That's his job. He gets to continue doing that. Pompeo has called Julian Assange and WikiLeaks a hostile, non-state intelligence service. That's what Mike Pompeo referred to Julian Assange as, a hostile non-state intelligence service, which is an epic slam, isn't it? He took Julian Assange's state away from him. We don't know. Is he solid? Is he liquid? Is he gaseous? Nobody knows. Nobody knows. But it's okay, because I think Julian Assange doesn't need a state. He has transcended a state, because the truth doesn't need a state. It just is, right? It just stays for what it is. I think it's important that we're all here today to fight for Julian. That's a very important thing to do. We have to become his voice, because he has been our voice for so long, right? I think we have a very odd relationship with the press in this country. We really do. We don't understand what that freedom actually is. Well, most of our media is controlled by the state. A lot of the corporate media is controlled by the state. That's really what corporate media is, right? And when you look at the rhetoric surrounding that, the freedom of the press is for everybody that publishes anything. Right? It's for me, it's for you, it's for actual journalists out there doing a job, revealing the truth about how corrupt our system actually is. It's not for these, quote, good journalists. And the system considers people like Brian Williams and Rachel Maddow and Wolf Blitzer good journalists. Yeah, right. We watch Brian Williams have an orgasm over missiles exploding on national television. Right? Rachel Maddow pretty much spent 3 years spreading a conspiracy theory of Russiagate nonstop. Right? Wolf Blitzer is more concerned with his beard than about journalism. These are not good journalists. These are, at best, corporate propagandists. At worst, they're CIA assets, is what they are. Yeah. Good. Freedom of press is for everybody that publishes anything, and that's what Julian Assange is. He's a publisher and a journalist. He revealed some of the most horrific crimes that the elites have committed against us, right? And I'm glad that you guys are here fighting for Assange to be free, because he really should be. Right now, Julian Assange is still stuck in Belmarsh prison because the United States and the UK are having a pissing contest as to who can be the world's best authoritarian government. So. That's a fun contest to be a part of in our current state. Yeah, it's ridiculous, man. We all have the right for freedom of the press. The CIA, who we've talked about a little bit, their motto, according to Mike Pompeo, is to lie, cheat, and steal. And that's exactly what they're doing right now by keeping Julian Assange in prison. They have the freedom to lie to us nonstop, to steal our freedoms away, and cheat us out of our best way of life. So I'm really glad that you guys are here. Thank you for fighting for Assange. And hopefully at the end of this, we'll have a free Assange so he can go home and be with his family. Thank you guys very much. Yeah. Thank you.